Buffalo.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The story of a little Alina Sedonik from St. Albert is truly an extraordinary one. In April, she was diagnosed with MPS6, a rare enzyme deficiency disease that occurs in newborn babies. With the disease left untreated, Alina would be vulnerable to life-threatening complications. Though a cure does not exist, a treatment does. The treatment has successfully treated 7 other Canadian children in neighboring provinces. For months, the Sedonik family attempted to raise little Alina's case with the government, but were met with barrier after barrier. They talked to the Alberta Rare Disease Funding Program, but were denied and waited desperately from the short-term exceptional drug therapy program for news. Every day without treatment meant another day of anxiety and uncertainty. But with the help of the Isaac Foundation and the leadership of Andrew McFadden, all Albertans began to hear and take up Alina's case. And, Mr. Speaker, they would not take no for an answer. After mounting public pressure, Alberta Health finally made the decision that should have been made months earlier, and they approved her funding. It's a reminder that we owe it to all Albertans to make sure that their health care system is there for them when rare diseases strike and extremely expensive treatments are their only hope. We can and we must do better. But I'd like to update you on how little Alina is doing after her first treatments. She's eating better. She has energy now. One afternoon, while Dad was running some errands, they got into a conversation. He was trying to explain to her what energy was and if she needed to she didn't need to rest as often. A little while later, Alina said, "Dad, I feel I can dance now." In a broken voice, her dad told her she can dance and looks forward to doing it together. It's a reminder for us to take a moment to celebrate life. And to Alina, dance on, little one, dance on.